idea of the song, right? You creating people as the composition. When you get into studio and you make this track, physical thing, not a physical thing, it's still a digital part, but you make it a thing. That recording is your master.
Right.
And then depending on your contract, that will stipulate who owns that thing. Right? So it's two different things. You've got your composition, which is the idea of the track, whatever it is, and the master, which is a version of the creation of the composition. And it gets, like, it's crazy. It's none of it is weird. But with the master recording, that ownership, right, that depends, that will then dictate how you can make money by selling it. Right? So if your record label says, cool, you can be a part of our record label, but we own the masters, then they've got control. It's all about control. They then have control over that portion of the copyright. They can do what they want to. They can sell it the way they want to, the price they want to, do what they want to. Even after the contract ends, somebody will stipulate that for a certain period of time, they're going to continue to own the masters. It can get messy, but yeah, just to know that there's those two different types of the copyright, the composition and the master. But I think from there, you can actually jump on, I think, the Xamarin website as well as the Capasso website, and then you can slowly start to piece it together. Yeah, that'll be it. It's a long conversation for another day.